As we hear the readings assigned for today, some of you may have noted that I don't look for special readings for any occasion unless the readings are really not suitable at all. But today's readings strike me as most appropriate to ponder as one reviews 7 years of episcopal ministry, and as you accept the fact that that ministry is drawing to a close. This particular reading has meaning for me because as a young seminarian, I remember the first time this reading came up for common meditation in the seminary. We all had a good laugh as we talked about the loincloth and what happens to a loincloth, and how the loincloth can get soiled. There are many images that one can take from that, but in pondering it in the context of today, the fact is that we seek to protect ourselves in different ways. We seek to hide the truth of our own being. And yet sooner or later, as life comes on, if we live it to the full, God has a way of showing us that truth. And although he tells Jeremiah to go and hide it after he has obviously worn it for a while, when the hiding doesn't really save anything. And for me, the first lesson there is that no matter what you do, sooner or later, you have to face the truth of a situation. And sometimes that truth is not always nice. It's not always nice. I can say, quite honestly, that this year has been the most difficult year of my episcopal ministry. And yet, in many ways, it has been the best year. Why? Because even up to yesterday, in talking with people. This past week, spending it with my brother bishops in Dominica, and we had occasions to just sit and talk about our episcopal ministry. It's been a very challenging year, especially challenging in the way of loving people, even when they don't seem to understand what you do. But in that love and in that attempt to love, and that's all it is, an attempt, you see the hand of God shaping you and hopefully shaping other people as well. The loincloth, when he finds it, is filthy, good for nothing. And that's, in a sense, sometimes is how one feels at the end of a struggle, good for nothing. And yet, the will of God still is that the Lord wants us to cling to him. He wants us to be his people, his glory, his honor. And it is in that context that we see how the parables of the kingdom show us a way forward where it's not about us. In a very real way, our life is a parable. The church today and all that is happening in the church today is a parable. And how do we read the parables? We have to listen. We have to understand that God is showing us things which sometimes you'd rather not face. And yet through it all, his kingdom is coming. His will is being revealed. And his love is being poured out. Amen.